Dumbbell step up instructions. Set up for the dumbbell step up by choosing a pair of dumbbells and holding them down at your sides. Stand up straight in front of a flat bench or other raised platform. Keep your eyes facing forward and a slight bend in your knees. This is the starting position. Lift your left knee and step onto the platform with your left foot. Once your foot is firmly planted on the platform, use your left heel to lift your body up and place your right foot on the platform as well. Pause briefly and then step back with your right leg and carefully return to the starting position. Repeat this motion for desired reps and then repeat while leading with your right foot. Exercise tips: keep your head up and back straight throughout the exercise. Never allow your back to round. Add intensity and difficulty by raising the platform. The higher the platform, the more intense the exercise. Start by using little to no weight. This exercise requires a good deal of balance and caution should be used. Dumbbell stiff leg deadlift video guide. Dumbbell stiff leg deadlift instructions. Set up for the dumbbell stiff leg deadlift by choosing a pair of dumbbells and holding them down at your sides. Stand up straight with a slight bend in your knees and your feet around shoulder width apart. This is your starting position. Keep your back as straight as possible and bend over at the waist, lowering the dumbbells over the tops of your feet. Your knees should be kept stationary during the movement. Focus on the stretch in your hamstrings, and continue to lower the dumbbells down as far as your hamstrings will let you comfortably. Now engage the hamstrings and begin to raise the dumbbells straight back up. Your eyes should be facing up and your shoulders back. This will prevent your lower back from rounding. Squeeze up through the glutes and hamstrings until you're standing straight up. Repeat for desired reps. Exercise tips: you must keep your eyes looking up at all times. As soon as you look down at the floor, your back will round. The dumbbells need to stay close to your body throughout the set. The further the dumbbells are from your body, the more strain is on your lower back. Focus on stretching the hamstrings out as you lower the dumbbells and contracting them as you raise back up. The greater the mind-muscle connection, the more you'll get out of this exercise. It's best to have your knees slightly bent during the set but fixed, i.e., bend them slightly but keep them locked in the same place throughout the set. During the descent, to protect your lower back, keep your weight back on the heels. Do not let your weight shift forward onto the toes. If you find your weight on the toes when at the bottom position of the exercise, you are performing it incorrectly. Do not relax at the bottom of the movement. Keep your legs, back and abdominals tight as you begin the ascent. Keep the rep timing slow and control the weight, especially when lowering. Remember, the focus is on stretch and contraction. One of the biggest mistakes people make when performing this exercise is bending over at the waist without moving the hips back. Instead of being supported by the large hamstring muscles, the weight is now placed almost entirely on the lower spine. Needless to say, this puts your back at great risk for injury. If you keep the weight close to your body, your hips will naturally move back. Technique is so important with this exercise. If you're just starting out, stand with your side to a mirror with a very light weight and practice the movement. Once you get the technique nailed, you'll be able to move up in weight and start building some killer hams and glutes. One-arm dumbbell row overview. The one-arm dumbbell row is a variation of the dumbbell row and an exercise used to build back muscle and strength. The back is a muscle group that requires a fair amount of variation. So, experiment with several different angles and hand positions to maximize your back muscle growth. Rows are a foundational movement pattern and are very important to train for balanced muscle growth and strength. So, experiment until you find a rowing variation that you enjoy and work on it. The one-arm dumbbell row can be performed during your back workouts, upper body workouts, pull workouts, and full body workouts. One-arm dumbbell row instructions. Assume a standing position while holding a dumbbell in one hand with a neutral grip. Hinge forward until your torso is roughly parallel with the floor or slightly above, and then begin the movement by driving the elbow behind the body while retracting the shoulder blade. Pull the dumbbell towards your body until the elbow is at or just past the midline, and then slowly lower the dumbbell back to the starting position under control. Repeat for the desired number of repetitions on both sides. One-arm dumbbell row tips. Experiment with head position and see which option, looking forward versus packing the neck, works better for you. Fight the urge to use your opposing arm to brace against your leg or any other implement. Keep some tone through your abdominals as you pull the dumbbell into your body to ensure you don't arch excessively through your spine. Don't allow momentum to dictate the movement, control the dumbbells throughout the entirety of each rep. If you feel your biceps being overused and your back remaining underactive, consider utilizing a false grip, i.e. don't wrap the thumb around the dumbbell. Don't allow the head to jut forward as you pull. Similarly, ensure the shoulder blade moves on the rib cage. Don't lock the shoulder blade down and just move through the glenohumeral joint. Reverse dumbbell bench press instructions. The reverse grip is the same as the dumbbell bench press except you use a reverse grip. Set up for the exercise by grasping a set of dumbbells and sitting on the end of a flat bench with the ends of the dumbbells resting on your knees. Slowly lay back on the bench and push the dumbbells straight up above your chest. Twist the dumbbells so that your palms are facing your shoulders. This is the starting position for the exercise. Slowly lower the dumbbells down, keeping your palms in line with your middle chest. When the handles get to around chest height, pause and raise the dumbbells back to the starting position. Repeat movement for desired reps. Dumbbell bench press tips: if you're using heavy weights, you can use your thighs to push the dumbbells back as you roll back on the flat bench. Don't let the dumbbells touch at the top of each rep. Keep the rep timing slow, lowering the dumbbells at a slower pace than raising them. Use a full range of motion, lower the dumbbells all the way down. Bent over dumbbell reverse fly overview. The bent over dumbbell reverse fly, also known as the bent over rear delt fly, is a great exercise to assist you in building a complete set of shoulders. Many lifters utilize the bent over dumbbell reverse fly to target the rear delts, an often lagging muscle for many lifters alike. Strengthening the rear delts by using the bent over rear delt fly can lead to improved posture and a greater level of strength on other lifts. Bent over dumbbell reverse fly instructions. Select the desired weight from the rack, then take a few steps back into an open area. Hinge from the hips until your body is almost parallel to the floor and allow the arms to hang straight down from the shoulders with a neutral grip. Take a deep breath and pull the dumbbells towards the ceiling using the rear deltoids. Slowly lower the dumbbells back to the starting position under control. Repeat for the desired number of repetitions. Bent over dumbbell reverse fly tips. Ideally, we want to focus on the rear deltoids, not the scapular retractors, so movement at the shoulder blade should be limited. Move the shoulder within the joint, not the shoulder blade on the ribcage. Keep the abs braced and don't arch the back at the top of the movement. If you can't hinge to 90 degrees, then hinge as far as comfortably possible while completing the exercise. Or, you could also take a seated position to complete the exercise as well. If you experience shoulder pain during the movement, then it may be beneficial to rotate the dumbbells until the thumbs are pointing away from one another and the palms are facing forward. This is also known as a supinated grip and will externally rotate the shoulder. Don't jut your head forward during the movement. This about stimulation for a small muscle group. Focus during the movement and don't just rely on momentum. Allow the arms to move freely but don't lock out the elbows. Zottmann curl overview. The standing Zottmann curl is a variation of the standing dumbbell curl and an exercise used to strengthen the muscles of the biceps. The Zottmann curl utilizes different hand positioning at different portions of the lift to capitalize on the strength of the lifter and maximize arm growth. The first portion, the regular curl, allows the lifter to focus on their bicep strength. The lowering portion, after already using a heavier weight than one would typically use in a dumbbell reverse curl, allows you to overload the forearms. Bicep isolation work is particularly helpful for those looking to achieve aesthetics and building a balanced physique. Zottmann curl instructions. Select the desired weight from the rack and assume a shoulder-width stance. Using a supinated grip, take a deep breath and curl the dumbbells towards your shoulders. Once the biceps are fully shortened, rotate the forearms to a pronated position, palms down, and slowly lower the weight back to the starting position. Repeat for the desired number of repetitions. Zottmann curl tips. Don't allow the elbows to shift behind the body. Similarly, make sure the shoulder doesn't shift forward in the socket as you lower the weight. Maintain a slight bend in the elbow at the bottom of the movement in order to keep tension through the biceps. Rotate the forearms slowly. Excessive velocity may cause issues within the elbows or wrists. Using a slow eccentric lowering portion of the exercise can help to improve tension and mind-muscle connection. Close grip dumbbell press. Close grip dumbbell press, aka crush press. Overview: the dumbbell crush press is a variation of the dumbbell bench press and an exercise used to build the muscles of the chest and triceps. The crush press is particularly effective in activating the chest, as you'll squeeze the pecs while pressing the dumbbells together. Additionally, the crush press incorporates the triceps more so than other bench press variations. This exercise is useful for bodybuilders trying to establish mind-muscle connection with their chest, as well as other lifters looking to build stronger triceps to assist them in other press variations. Close grip dumbbell press, aka crush press. Instructions: pick up the dumbbells off the floor using a neutral grip, palms facing in. Position the ends of the dumbbells in your hip crease, and sit down on the bench. To get into position, lay back and keep the weights close to your chest. Once you are in position, take a deep breath, crush the dumbbells together, then press them to lock out at the top. Continue to push the dumbbells together while lowering them under control as far as comfortably possible. Once the dumbbells touch your chest, push them back to the starting position. Repeat for the desired number of repetitions. *** Dropping the dumbbells to the side is discouraged unless you are experienced with the technique or using excessively heavy weights. *** Ideally you should twist the dumbbells back to neutral, palms facing each other, bring your knees up so the ends of the dumbbells are touching your thighs, then use the weight of the dumbbells to rock back to an upright, seated position. Close grip dumbbell press, aka crush press. Tips: maintain more tension through the pecs by not locking out the elbows entirely. Squeeze the dumbbells as tight as possible to improve a phenomenon known as irradiation, which promotes greater shoulder stability. Keep your shoulder blades pinched together to ensure the shoulders remain in a safe position. Think of the movement as a fly combined with a press. Press together while pressing horizontally. If you're feeling pain within the shoulder joint itself, specifically at the front, ensure your shoulder blades are slightly retracted and try to keep the shoulder girdle packed. Ensure you maintain some tension in your abs and don't allow your lower back to excessive arch. Keep your feet flat on the floor and don't allow the lower body to move during the set. Please like, share, comment and subscribe this video. Thanks for watching my video. We'll be right back.